Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This is another good day. We bless the Lord God Almighty for this great and fabulous day. Father, we thank you for this wonderful day. We glorify your name as we meditate on your word, as we pray that you guide and direct us. Let your grace be made sufficient for us, O God Almighty. Lord, take charge and take control of our worship, and your word that we speak will make meaning and great impact upon our lives today and forever in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to your name, O God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you are my God. You are altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you are my God. You are altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Ieva rabashekere bosotorobo sendeya. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Bow down before you, Lord. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We exalt you, Lord. Lord Jesus, you are so lovely. You are so wonderful. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for your grace made sufficient for us. Thank you for forgiving us our sins. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for dying on the cross for our sins and cleansing us from all unrighteousness. Thank you for saving our souls. Thank you for protection. Glory be to your name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. So, beloved, the topic today is the ministry of angels, part 1. Our main text will be taken from Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14. I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. Therefore, angels are only servants, spirits sent to care for people who inherit salvation. And the Good News Translation says, what are the angels then? They are spirits who serve God and are sent by Him to those who are to receive salvation. What are angels? The name angel is from the Greek word angelos. It means messenger or envoy, someone sent from God. And then the Hebrew word is malak. It also means messenger. So whether it is Hebrew or Greek, they both mean messenger, one sent from God. We can safely conclude, therefore, that angels are God's servants or spirit messengers or ministering spirits sent by Him to help and serve those who receive or inherit salvation. Hebrews 1:14. The word angel is also used for describing physical individuals and supernatural beings. Angels were created at the foundation of the earth. I'm talking about the spiritual beings. They were created at the foundation of the earth before the creation of man. The kind of man, therefore, is a little lower than the angels. Psalm 8, verse 4 to 5. What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. But the regenerated man is above angels, and will even judge angels at the end of the age, because he is born of God. 1 Corinthians 6:3 says, know ye not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life? Angels were not born of God, but were made. But we, the believers, the regenerated ones, are born again, born of God, born of His Spirit. In addition, we believers are seated with Christ in heavenly places. Ephesians 2:6-7. Now, let us consider what happened at the pool of Bethesda. I specifically and deliberately left out a particular part that I did not deliberate on when I treated that topic on taking responsibility, because I reserved it for today's topic, which is the
the ministry of angels. Now, John chapter 5, New King James Version, verse 1. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having 5 arches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. Verse 4. For an angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was made well of whatever disease he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. I'll stop there. Just like an angel stirred the water in the pool of Bethesda and brought about the healing of all sorts of diseases and infirmities, so the Holy Spirit of God, through the angels of God, do the same in our lives as Christians. So you can see there the very vital function of the angel. Angels are ministering spirits. Angels are God's messengers. That angel was sent by God and by the power of the Holy Spirit. Because angels don't have power of their own. And these angels stirred up the water. May the Lord send you, your angel, to stir up the waters that will bring a turnaround in your life, your family, your business, and ministry today in the name of Jesus. One word that they will put in for you will grant you your request or give you the required favor. Just as a complimentary card from such a person will stir up the waters that will bring about the fulfillment of your destiny and your goal. At times, being in their company alone, in the company of that destiny angel, is enough to give you breakthrough. Let's look at lessons to learn from this text. One, even though the water is stirred, not everybody benefits physically. Similarly, even though every Christian is anointed or blessed with the Holy Spirit, and we even have angels at our beck and call, not everyone experiences the physical manifestations of this Holy Spirit and the angels. To draw from the well of the Spirit, we have to exercise our faith by following up our beliefs with corresponding actions. Same goes for the divine angels sent to us. Though the sick man was at the pool where the water was stirred, he was still in that condition for 38 years. So the fact that the pool has been stirred, the fact that Holy Spirit is there, does not automatically mean that the person will be healed or have problems solved or easy life. It then all depends on the person, how we all make out our salvation and how we exercise our faith. Number two, what the angels stir up is the water, the word of God. In the text, the word of God. So we need to study the word of God and speak the word of God, because Bible says in John 15 that the word washes us clean. So we are washed clean by the word of God. We are washed clean of infirmity. We are washed clean of diseases and sicknesses by the word of God. So we should read the word of God. We should study the word of God. We should meditate upon the word of God. We should assimilate the word of God. In fact, we should eat the word of God, digest the word of God, and speak the word of God. Number three, angels don't force anyone to accept their services. Neither does God. Look at that place. The angel will stir the water. Anyone that falls in, the angel will not move anybody into the water. The angel will not force it on anyone. The choice is yours. Revelation 3:20 says, "Behold, I stand at the door." That is Jesus speaking now. "And I knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me." Beloved, angels, again, are ministering spirits, God's messengers, God's servants. After the temptation of Jesus, angels came and ministered to him. Matthew chapter 4 verse 11. When he was to resurrect from the dead, angels again came down and rolled the stone away from the entrance of the tomb. Matthew chapter 28 verse 2. If Jesus needed the ministrations of the angels, then you and I cannot do without them. The angel rolled away the stone and sat on the stone, so that the stone will not roll back again. That's why the scripture says, this sickness, this infirmity, that problem will never return a second time to your life in the name of Jesus. As God heals you today, it will be forever in Jesus' mighty name. So now, what do the angels minister and how do they minister to us? Bible says they are ministry angels. Angels minister protection, encouragement, strength, ideas, directions, comfort, and so on and so forth. But I'm just going to look at a few today, and then in part 2, we'll look at more by the grace of God. majorly the minister number one information messages from the throne of God, from God to us. And this host of angels are led by Archangel Gabriel. Luke chapter 1 verse 19. And the angel answering said unto him, I am Gabriel that stand in the presence of God, and I'm sent to speak unto thee and to show thee these glad tidings. So angel brings good tidings, brings God's messages, brings God's revelation, brings God's information, reveals this to us by the Spirit of the Living God. Then number two, angels minister defense. They defend us, they protect us, they guard us. And this set of angels are led by Archangel Michael. They fight wars and they fight battles on our behalf. Every spiritual battle is fought by this group of angels led by Archangel Michael. They are guardian angels. They execute God's judgment on his enemies and our enemies. You must yield to the Spirit of God for the angels to obey you. You must be submissive to God before the angels will obey you. I pray that as we yield to the Spirit of God, may they execute judgment on your enemies in the name of Jesus. May they fight your battles for you and grant you victory even today in the name of Jesus. Psalm 91 verse 10 to 12, reading from Message Translation. Evil can't get close to you. Harm can't get through the door. He ordered his angels to guide you wherever you go. If you stumble, they will catch you. Their job is to keep you from falling. Take note of that. Their job is to keep you from falling. You will walk unharmed among lions and snakes and kick your young lions and serpents from the path. Amplified says in verse 11, he will give his angels, a special one, charge over you to accompany and defend and preserve you in all your ways, in all your ways of obedience and service. So if you don't obey God's word and serve God, then you are hindering your angels from obeying you. No wonder the scripture says, if they will obey and serve him, they will eat of the good of the land. So willingness and obedience, very necessary for the angels to go to work in our lives. And it says the angels will accompany us, they will defend us, they will preserve us. So I pray, beloved, that today, as we yield ourselves to the Lord, that the Lord God Almighty will send his angels and give them special orders to protect you and I wherever we go today in the name of Jesus. They will defend us from all harm, that no evil or disease will infect us in the name of Jesus Christ. We'll be far from coronavirus, we'll be far from COVID-19 in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Our memory verse today is Hebrews 1:14, which is our main text as well. What are the angels then from the Good News Translation? They are spirits who serve God and are sent by him to help those who are to receive salvation. Keep this at the back of your mind. Remember that the angels of God are God's spirit messengers. They are ministry angels to serve you. They are sent to help you because you have received salvation. No matter the help you need today, may the angel of God grant that for you. May the angel of God guide you. He will minister to you. The angels of God, by the grace of God, knows exactly what you need. As they minister to you, you will go safely in safety. You'll be protected. You'll be guided. You'll be covered in the name of Jesus. Amen. For those who are not born again, just pray now and say, Lord, as I believe in you, I confess you as my Lord and Savior, and I know you died for my sake and you are coming back again. I dedicate my life to you. Take control. Help me, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Father, I commit those who are just born again and all who have been born again. I commit everyone that have listened today into the hands of God. Guide them, protect them, keep them. Let today, O God, be a special day for them, O God. Dispatch special angels to guide them, to lead them, to protect them. Today, O God Almighty, let them not fall, let them not stumble. Let them not fall into the trap of the wicked in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for leading them. Thank you for guiding them. Thank you for covering them from diseases and sicknesses that are in the land. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. And don't forget, Jesus loves you, and righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people.